Hello, I'm Aubrey Shepherd, and I want to share some photos. Some of them good, some of them bad, and some of them maybe sad. Okay, that's the good news. Part of the good news this week, it finally rained. We're doing this on the 13th, I mean the 19th of September 2011, and there are new things in bloom. It was a dry day there just before the rain finally came, and Cindy Cope and I were out looking for monarch caterpillars that she could use in her classes. That's Asclepias fritella, and we found a lot of them. If you could see that picture again, which you can online on my Flickr site and on some of the blogs, you'll see that there were some like four, five, six in that picture. And that is Liatris. I keep showing Liatris from the Pinnacle Prairie because it bloomed late and most of the plants are actually lying down, so in order to get a picture, I have to hold one up. But that particular one's been standing, so that's called spurge, Spurge, and as you can tell from the size of my fingers and my fingerprints, that's a very tiny flower. But that's a fairly good close-up, and it's adjusted a little bit. That's a soldier beetle, and left. And it's supposedly maybe the dandelion soldier beetle, but I haven't seen one on a dandelion yet this year to make me believe it. The thing on the right was a little let's see, cucumber beetle, and it's in the family with the ladybug, so it's just a different color. That's Asclepias viridis. That's regrowth out on Pinnacle Prairie. And somebody here predicted I'd show one of those. And here comes a look at the tiny butterfly in the center. See the two sides, the two eyes it appears on the wings. Okay, there you go. That one's wing is damaged, and it really is. Amazing. These butterflies, this particular kind, lives all summer. I've been trying to get a decent picture of them all summer. That one probably was sat there long enough because he was tired of flying with a partial wing missing there on the left side. So you can see what the back looks like. There are big spots and small spots with yellow around them on the outside of the wings. And I had a hard time getting a shot with the wings open, so I contented myself with something like this. Now that is from the back, but it shows the right wing a little bit. He kept when he light on some grass there showing off. They're grass dependent insects. They butterflies. They ha their host plants are some of the native grass species. And that's a tiny aster. It's a very tiny aster. You can't tell just how tiny it is, but it's one that's fingernail sized. And there's button bush. That's also on Pinnacle Prairie, and you can see some of the factory in the far background. Of course, that button bush is far past flower, and it's going to seed. So, in this shot, you see a bunch of those tiny asters. They're incredibly important for the butterflies and bees and things this time of year. Even though they're tiny, you'll see huge butterflies on them sometime. I don't think I've found that kind of picture. Okay, this is horehound, or has several other names, and it's in the mint family. And you see the flowers are very small; they grow around the stem. That's why it's hard to get good photos of them. And tried to crop one or two of those and make them bigger. Again, we get out on Pinnacle Prairie to see something bright red, and that is the ironweed. And here's I believe this one's called bitterweed. Okay, I get bitterweed and smartweed. No, not smartweed. Bitterweed and stink us. stinkweed. Anyway, get some of those flowers mixed up. That's horse nettle. Okay, these two photos in a row show you four houses being built within one block, fairly narrow lot on South Church Avenue near Wiggins Church. And the reason I show you these, it emphasizes why infill on wet prairie land in Fayetteville is not such a good idea, because there won't be any place for kids to play on that lot or anybody to walk a dog on their own property. And you see, they've red dirted all the way back near to the to 7th Street. So, it's just terrible for the watershed to do that. And till next time, this is Aubrey Shepherd asking you to do your part to help keep the water clean, the air pure, and the woods green. See ya. Hello, I'm Aubrey Shepherd, and we'll go to a couple of events in Fayetteville from the previous weekend. This is the 19th of September 2011, and most people who live in Fayetteville a long time know Marion Orton. She was mayor, and in 1975, they gave her this plaque with Mayor Marion Orton, First Lady of Fayetteville. And for the people at the station, you may be seeing this on Cat Channel, formerly it's now Your Media. It's always, however, Fayetteville's public access station. And there's a lady, she's the a minister in Fayetteville, talking about moving somewhere else. That's Jo Bennett. She and Professor Dick Bennett were married for many years, and she was at the Peace Heroes Banquet. That's Professor Bennett at left, and a lady who used to be a librarian for the Omni Center and so forth. There's City Attorney Kit Williams and his wife at the Peace Heroes Banquet. Good to see them out. And that's a tiny legume. Legume just means a flower on a plant that comes is a family member of beans and peas. That spider, see that pretty little spider on that goldenrod? Well, that little spider is up to no good. We'll get back to him in a minute. You'll see him up to some of his naughty tricks, but it's all nature. This is an unusual ironweed in that you see the leaves are leaves and stems have turned partially red. Okay, I didn't show maybe this exact one, but I've shown one of these guys quite a few times on bone set now, and we'll find out the name of those one of these days. I know the name of this. It's one of my favorite tiny or small butterflies, and they're so friendly they light on your clothes. And this one got on my thumb, and it's at World Peace Wetland Prairie. And the reason there are lots of these around, they're dependent. Their caterpillars have to live on a tree that we have in plenty down there, and it's the hackberry tree. So this is called a hackberry butterfly. Some references to the hackberry emperor. Now this is a moth, and you wouldn't even guess it was a moth until you see it fly away. Could make it do that. This is an insect on an old wall, old shed wall, and I don't know exactly what it is, but I think it's either a moth or some kind of fly. Well, no, the eyes are too big for flies, so must be a moth. Maybe I've got a better angle here to show what it looks like from another angle. I'm not sure I got an extra picture on there. This one's sure staying on there a long time for some reason. So we could talk a lot. That's a city machine that was fenced off for the weekend, but it had been digging debris out of the Spout Spring branch along South College Avenue. That's Lauren Hawkins. She's just brought out and added to her brush pile that got cleared away not long ago, but she's making another one by digging out the roots of honeysuckle. Okay, there is the naughty spider who did that right before my eyes. That's the kind of creature he was eating at that point. And you see, he can hide in there, and there may be one lurking in one of those flowers just waiting for one of these hoverflies to get too close and settle in. If they hover, they're okay. That was the end of that last shot, was about spring branch after it was scraped out. That was this morning, which is the 19th of September. They did a good job of getting a lot of logs and debris out of there, but of course it left a lot of soil loose in there, Diddley Road, and some of it might go all the way to Beaver Lake as a siltation, the worst pollutant. Till next time, this is Albert Shepard asking you to do your part to help keep the water clean, the air pure, and the woods green. See you.